I'm going to discuss some of the approaches you should use when you're solving problems. Am I going to do this in the context of a thermodynamics problem, a closed system energy balance that I'll use as an example? And so the problem statement is here. And of course, the first thing you want to do is read the problem statement and read it more than once. And then the next thing is to draw a diagram. So what I'm going to do is pause first, draw a diagram, and then let's continue looking at how to solve this problem. So notice that when drawing the diagram, one of the things that's important is to list all the knowns and then the unknowns. In this case, we don't know the temperature, and we don't know if liquid is present. So we don't know if we have two phases or all vapor, since as we're adding heat at constant pressure, we're going to vaporize some liquid at least. And so this is the first step. We have knowns, unknowns, and a diagram. So our second step then is to plan. In other words, plan how we're going to do the solution before we do it. So that means picking a system. In this case, it's the water, all of the water, whether it's liquid or vapor, in the piston and cylinder. And then this is an energy balance. So first law is the first thing we're going to do for a closed system. And closed system at constant pressure. And so this means to solve the first law, we're going to need initial final conditions. So we're going to use the steam tables to look up the properties of steam at the different conditions. And then we're going to determine what is the final state, and that means temperature and phases present. Now that we've planned out, let's actually do the solutions. That means first writing down the first law, which for a closed system, change in internal energy is Q plus W. Because it's constant pressure, I'm using notation system does work, then energy is removed from the system. So constant pressure times delta V. And I'm going to rewrite this as minus delta PV. And the reason I'm doing that is because I can see I can now rearrange this equation. Delta U plus delta PV is equal to Q. And delta U plus delta PV is delta H. So this means I can use delta H values from the steam tables. I know the value of Q. So delta H is the final enthalpy per kilogram minus the initial enthalpy, and that's going to be equal to Q, which is 2,000 kilojoules as given in the problem statement. That's the amount of heat added. So I'm going to go to the steam tables, and for H1, because it's a mixture, it would be mass of the liquid, enthalpy per kilogram of the liquid, plus the mass of the vapor, enthalpy per kilogram of the vapor. So I'm going to write these numbers down. I'm going to pause and fill in the numbers from the steam tables. So H1, 851.1 kilojoules, and this is for 1 kilogram. So notice when I wrote the numbers down, I put the units in. Very good practice to have the units in always when solving problems. You see the units cancel, we end up with kilojoules. And so then our energy balance says that H2 is H1 plus Q. So 2,851.1 kilojoules is our final enthalpy. So the first thing we can do is, here is the saturated vapor enthalpy, and this number is greater than 2749. So we can conclude we have superheated vapor, which is one of the questions we wanted to answer. And now the question is, what is the temperature? So we go back to the steam tables. The pressure has stayed constant. The enthalpy is 2851.1 kilojoules. So two properties of steam, single component, uniquely determine this. And so we can go to the steam tables. And depending on how accurate and how detailed our steam tables are, we may have to interpolate. But if we use detailed steam tables, we can directly determine the temperature. Temperature for this pressure, this enthalpy, is 198 degrees C. And with significant figures, we would call this 200 degrees C. So, important aspect to solving problems. Of course, answer should have units. Should have correct number of significant figures. And then we should check, is the answer reasonable? Is this a reasonable answer? Well, if we look up the saturation temperature at this pressure, it's 151.9 degrees C. And so 200 is greater than this, as we would expect. We put energy in. We've put enough energy to vaporize all the liquid. That seems pretty reasonable from the delta H of vaporization, the steam tables. And so for this problem, there's not a lot of checking we can do, but the checking that we do makes it look reasonable. And in general, that's what we're looking for. Does this look reasonable? Do I get units that are correct from the calculations? And so the idea, if you're systematic in solving problems, always drawing a diagram, listing the knowns and unknowns, planning out the solution before substituting in the numbers, more effective at solving problems.